our next guest. He's hosting live Instagram sessions writing songs from scratch. So get your guitars at the ready as we're joined by the nicest bloke in the business and Rachel Horn's favourite person on earth. It's Snow Patrol's Gary Lightbody.
Yeah, don't tell Alex Horn whatever you do. Good morning, Gary.
Hello, hello,
hello. Just here, if it just lay here. Oh, my goodness me. How are you, gal?
I'm good, thank you very much. Are you well?
We're very well, thank you very much. We're very lucky. We're still at work. We're very well. Our families are safe, and we're all doing what we can to stay together. Did you watch the big One World concert on Saturday?
I didn't watch it because I was busy working on this track that I sent you, so I didn't get to see it. Was it good?
Oh, it's amazing. 8 hours, 5 minutes. It's all on YouTube. You can catch up with it.
I'm going to watch some of it, yeah.
It was very Live Aid-esque, you know, but different and in and of itself, but it was very now, and it was really exciting, Gary, if you know what I mean.
I tell you, what was the highlight? What was your favourite bit?
Well, we've all got different bits. I mean, I think, you know, it might sound quite predictable, and I'm sorry to say this again, because I've said it a few times already this morning, but I once made a film with the Stones on tour, and I've seen them a few times, small gigs, big gigs, some as big as your wrist. But Mick Jagger singing You Can't Always Got What You Want on his acoustic guitar, with his acoustic guitar in his living room, it was off the charts.
Wow. Well, I'm definitely going to be checking that out.
You got McCartney. Yeah, you got McCartney, Lady Madonna-ing in his living room. You got Elton in his garden in Windsor singing "I'm Still Standing." You got Lady Gaga, "Smile When Your Heart Is Aching." You got Jack Johnson on the steps of his Malibu beach house in his shorts and his scruffy t-shirt and a really beaten up guitar playing "Better Together." I mean, it was gold after gold after gold.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
All right, so what were you up to, and what have you sent us, and how can we help?
Well, I mean, no, it's not about help so much. I just wanted I wanted to maybe get the word out there a bit and see what the crack was. But we've been writing songs on Instagram every Saturday at 8 p.m. On Instagram Live. I go on there and just whoever comes on, I get them to give me some chords, and then I put the chords into a sort of some sort of order. I do a melody. I do that four times. Everyone picks their favorite melody. That's the one that we work on, and then I get them to give me lyric ideas, and I do that for about 20 minutes, and then I go offline for about an hour, put all the lyric ideas together, and then I come back online and I play the finished song. The whole thing takes about 90 minutes, and we've done it for the last 5 Saturdays, and we got 5 songs.
And how does it feel to be doing that so publicly, so naked, if you like?
Well, I didn't. The first week, I didn't know what was happening. I was kind of making it up as we were going along. We've got a kind of a routine now. The one I just described is kind of that routine that I made up that first week, and it worked really well. And yet, before I go on, about 5 minutes before I go on, I think, ooh, hope something happens this week, because I kind of expect at some point, you know, at 1 week there's going to be nothing. You know, nothing will happen. You know, because that's just. I mean, some songs have taken me 5 years to write, Chris. So you know what I mean. It's like this is, it does, it's got to come crashing down at some point, you would think. But it's been really fun so far.
Yeah, I don't think it will. I mean, I remember that period when you couldn't write for Toffee, could you? You couldn't arrest yourself in a studio, and now here you are, you're knocking out tunes every 90 minutes. Isn't it bizarre? Isn't life bizarre?
It does help that, you know, other people are writing the lyrics and I'm just jotting them down. But that does take a bit of pressure off. I mean, at the end of this, we're going to put them, like, I'm going to try and do 10 or 12. We're going to put it together in an album, and the album will go. I've already spoken to the record company. They're very happy with doing this. It's all going to go to charity. So whatever we make from it, the money will go where it's needed. You know, in these times.
And does it feel different when you're going through this process?
Yeah, I mean, you don't have time to really, you know, I don't have time to kind of get in my own head about it, really.
Yeah.
Which I don't talk myself out of anything. Everything is just yes. It's kind of like the way I've never had improvisational acting lessons, but it's kind of the way I've heard that works. You just keep having to say yes to everything. You can't say no. So this, it just keeps moving forward. I don't give myself time to kind of reflect. It's just, It's kind of like just throwing myself into the deep end every week.
Yeah, there's two takes
keep
on that.
Sharp.
There's just show up and keep saying yes, and also never let perfect be the enemy of good, which I also like.
Yes, exactly. And then I send the vocal and the guitar to the lovely Mr. Ian Archer, who's been producing the songs up, and then the rest of the guys, the song I sent you guys, the rest of the guys in the band haven't played on that yet, but they will, of course. And the version you have is a very early version.
I love that.
It's all done by Ian, and that's phenomenal.
Right, so what we can tell everybody now, Saturday Songwrite, Saturdays at 8 p.m, is at Instagram at Snow Patrol, Saturday Songwrite. So every Monday you're going to come on the show and you're going to gift us the latest song, is that right?
I'll come back on in a month and we'll play the best song from the last four, from the next 4 weeks.
Okay, we'll take a
moment. If you're up for playing the one from Saturday, that'd be great. And I will come back on and play another one.
We are. Okay, so it's Gary Lightbody. All it says on my computer here is Gary Lightbody, Insta song, brackets, no title.
There's literally no title yet.
Do you want to give us a vibe on the song or who was involved? Which contributions came from where on the planet?
It was everywhere. I saw people were saying from Argentina, from all over America, from Brazil, in Asia, although it's very early in the morning in Asia at 8 o'clock in the UK, but from all over Europe, and people give such, every week, people give such amazing suggestions for lyrics, and there's always really a load of good crack on there. Like, it's been really fun.
Are you loving it?
I really love it. Yeah. It's the lyrics that have been coming in have been phenomenal. Really, really good.
In what ways? Because that's it from you. I mean, yeah, that's saying something. What do you mean that the lyrics have been phenomenal?
Well, every week, I'm just looking at the pages from this week. I took four pages of lyrics. I try and get people to give me short phrases, like two words, three words, four words, rather than whole sentences or paragraphs, because I can't read them all as they fly past on the screen. But literally, I have four pages where it's a line from each person or a few words from each person, and I've maybe used, a song only has, 20 lines in it or 25 or 30 lines in it, most, pop songs. And there's so much stuff left on here, and there's so much great stuff left. Every week there's stuff that I just can't fit in the song, and there's always kind of like surplus great stuff, I could make many albums out of it.
And because for us musical pros, this is how we can begin to understand the importance of, say, Bernie Taupin to Elton John, where perhaps before we couldn't.
For sure. I mean, I've always written my own lyrics, and I've had to write some of the, and I have to join up the dots and everything and make everything make sense, and I'll add my own stuff in as well, but in every single line, there will be something from somebody on Instagram. I'll make sure that there's something from on there in each line in the song, so that none of it sort of gets, it doesn't get to a point where I'm just filling in too much of it. I want it to be a collaborative thing.
All right, cool. And I hear California, relatively, of course, everything is relative at the moment. Relatively is coping very well with the lockdown.
California here, our California governor and the LA mayor were pretty quick off the mark in terms of getting things sort of shutting up shop and stuff like that. So we were lucky here.
All right, pal. Okay, Gary Lightbody live from Los Angeles, where it's now, I would imagine, 13 minutes to 1 in the morning. This is Saturday Songwrite, Saturday's 8 p.m, Instagram at Snow Patrol, once again, this coming weekend. And here you have it. It's Gary Lightbody, Insta song, in brackets, no title, work in progress. Thank you, Gal.
No more, you're so far from me. On the edge of all that's a new world, new sea. I can hear you, can you hear me loud and clear? In this magic mayhem, life is simple, dear. We were in love and drunk and free. We did it all majestically in the dark, tripping over ourselves. Falling down, turning on. Goodbye, dark. Hello, dawn. Bouncing joy, tender heartbreak. Climb up here to me now. Love on fire, I don't know how. It makes sense only to us. Between the upside downness of the waking world and the ancient history of my dreams of you, there's another kingdom where we'll meet again. With the fire behind us and the light ahead. We were in love and drunk and free. We did it all majestically in the dark, tripping over ourselves. Falling down, turning on. Goodbye, dark. Hello, dawn. Bouncing joy, tender heartbreak. Climb up here to me now. Love on fire, but to know how. It makes sense only to us. Climb up here to me now. Love on fire, don't know how. It makes sense only to us.
Earth calling Rachel, Earth calling Rachel. You're right there? In a world of your own. Well, actually, there was one other person in it with you, wasn't there? And it wasn't anybody that you're related to.
He's just so hypnotic.
You couldn't tell. Rachel, I couldn't tell. Look at you on the screen there. Right, have you stopped salivating?
It's not that.
Wipe round your mouth, for heaven's sake.
Voice.
Come on.
It's the way he says
I know.
Here.
I'm joking.
He uses that word here. There's something about the way he said it. It's magical.
He really is a very special person, isn't he, Gary Lightbody? And what a wonderful thing he's doing. So if you want to get involved, do. Or just watch what's going on. Saturday Songwrites. Saturdays at 8 p.m. Instagram at Snow Patrol. And this is not dissimilar to what I was talking about with the One World concert, the Global Citizen One World concert. It's the fact that now, you know, this is a tipping point of entertainment. Especially visually, you know, and I suppose musically, and I don't know, but a lot of the TV shows that we know and love are being made at the homes of the people, being broadcast from the homes of the people that usually are on them in a TV studio somewhere, whether it's, you know, around Shepherd's Bush or, you know, in the valley over there in California or wherever. And it's so funny because the best of the best is shining through. And other shows are falling by the wayside because without the audience and without, you know, the sort of studio embellishment, you know, they're good on normal telly, but, you know, where will this leave normal telly? You know, and this does mean that Gary Lightbody can go online every Saturday night for the rest of his life and do this, you know, and he could have done that before, but people weren't aware of it. But now it's so much more personal, isn't it? It's quite radio-y like, actually. Mm. It's quite literary. It's quite, you know, one-on-one. You feel, because, you know, they're there, warts and all, and they're better than ever. These artists are better than ever when they're at home just doing what they do. Because this is where it all started. It all started, didn't it? In their bedrooms. With them picking up a guitar or being inspired by listening to this, you know, one song here, or an uncle coming around with a groove from another corner of the planet. And, you know, this is where the magic happens. We think the stage, you know, the arenas, the stadiums. We think that's where the magic happens, and it is one kind of magic, but it's amplified, and you know it's synthesized. But this is where the real magic happens. You're being allowed into the inner sanctum, and this is where they do what they do, and they do it so well. And